by your grace and for your glory. Amen.
Contrary to what people believe, there is a God who made and rules over the universe and all that it contains. And that God is three in one. Three persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, Yahweh. That God made mankind to worship and serve Him, to give his heart to Him, and to do what he tells him to do, which brings that God glory and mankind complete and continuous satisfaction. Instead of worshiping and serving God, mankind rebelled against God, basically saying, I'm not going to worship and serve you. I'm going to worship and serve, ultimately, myself. The penalty for that rebellion is death. First, spiritual death. Mankind no longer had a shared life with God. And as part of that, a personal relationship with God in which God was his God and King. That spiritual death leads to physical death and ultimately the second death, to spending eternity in hell, where one will suffer unimaginably for one's sins against God. The bad news is this. Every person is conceived a sinner headed to hell. The good news is this, that God, out of love for sinners and ultimately himself and his glory, God the Father sent God the Son, who added humanity to his deity, fully God and fully man, Jesus the Christ, to save sinners. To do that, Jesus, in the place of sinners, perfectly obeyed the law of God and God the Father, and suffered and died to pay the full penalty for their sins. He was buried, and on the third day, he rose from the dead, never to die again. He has been exalted to the right hand of God the Father, where he is ruling as Lord over all. And a day is coming when he will judge every person in righteousness. And now, God is commanding all people everywhere to repent, to turn from their sins, including any, quote, good works they're trusting in to get right with God. Baptism, communion, confirmation, church attendance, to turn from all of that and to turn to God through faith and faith alone in the crucified and risen Lord Jesus Christ. The person who does that, God will forgive them for all their sins. I don't care how bad their sins are. God will forgive them and make them right with him. And that person will have a shared life with God and a personal relationship with God. And God will be that person's God. If you have never gotten right with God, then God's word to you is to repent and believe. Turn from your sins, turn from any good works you're trusting in, and put your trust solely in the crucified and risen Lord Jesus Christ. For those of us who have done that, worship and serve God. Mankind will never find complete and continuous satisfaction in money, possessions, food, alcohol, drugs, sex, entertainment, or anything else, or anyone else. It can only be found in God. Find it in God. Worship and serve.
My name is Keziah.
And my name is Jantrew.
On the basis of 1 Corinthians 10:31 and Matthew 28:19, the mission of the Arapaho FCA Huddle is to glorify God and as part of that, make followers of the Lord Jesus Christ, outside of sports and in sports.
By the grace of God, the Arapaho FCA Huddle will accomplish its mission by doing the following four things. One, pursuing. That is pursuing God in Christ's likeness.
Two, praying. That is praying collectively and individually.
Three, proclaiming. That is proclaiming God's word.
And four, participating. That is participating in God's work.
On behalf of the Arapaho FCA Huddle, we invite you, whether it's being a part of our huddle or simply following us on social media, to join us, to be a part of our team. A team that's mission is to glorify God and as part of that, make followers of the Lord Jesus Christ, outside of sports and in sports.
You can follow us on Facebook at Arapaho Nebraska FCA.
And you can follow us on Twitter at FCA Arapaho and
God glorified,
Christ followed.
Lord, thank you. To you be the glory.